Hello, this is Jason from Forest Marsh Group. This video will show you how to use the Excel Data Aggregation Template to submit your data for the 2018 Election Administration Voting Survey, or EAVS. We'll cover how to download the template from the EAVS portal, how to enter data, how to error check your data and respond to the issues that are flagged for you to review, and how to submit your completed template. A quick note before we begin. I have Excel 2010 installed on my computer, and if you have another software version like Excel 2007 or 2013, the pop-up boxes and Excel menu will look a little different from what you see here. The steps to follow are the same, though. We've released a written guide to using the 2018 data templates that will walk you through all the processes I'm going to show you and which will explain any differences with other software versions. You can find that guide on the EAVS portal. First, I'll show you how to locate the Excel data aggregation template and download it so you can enter your data into it. You'll want to go to the EAVS portal, EAVSPORTAL.com, and click login in either the upper right-hand corner or the center of the portal homepage. Enter your username and password into the text boxes. If you don't know your login information, contact the EAVS technical support team. Once you've logged in, you'll see some resources on the password-protected part of the portal. First, in the center of the screen, you'll see a file upload link. This will allow you to upload files from your own computer and send them along to the EAVS team. Below that, you'll see a series of links under downloads. These are templates and documents that the EAVS team has put together to help you with the survey. Below that, you'll see a table of uploaded files. You can see the names of the files you've uploaded and the date and time they were uploaded. The data aggregation template is under the downloads header. You'll see it right here titled 2018 EAVS Data Aggregation Template.xlsm. Click on the link to begin the download process. Once the file has downloaded, it will appear in the bottom left corner of the screen. I'm going to left click it on the file to open it immediately. Once the file opens, it opens in protected view. This mode disables editing and links in macros to protect you from malicious files. However, the data aggregation template is from a trusted source and is safe to open, so click Enable Editing in the top left-hand part of the screen. This will turn it into a document you can edit and input data into. Next, you'll want to click the Enable Content button that pops up. This will enable the macros this template uses to help check your data. You should only have to click the Enable Editing button once after you download the template, but you may have to click the Enable Content every time you open the template. Before you begin working on this document, you'll want to save it to a location on your computer so you can find it later. Do this by clicking the File menu in the top left corner of your screen and clicking Save As. From here, you can choose the folder to save the document in and give the document a new title if you want to. From there, click Save, and the document will save to the location you have selected. I'm just going to save on my desktop for now. You're ready to begin working in the file. If you forget to save the template to another location, check the Downloads folder on your computer. I also recommend that you resave the file often as you're working in it to make sure you don't lose any of the data you've entered. Before we begin entering data, let me show you around the template. On the left-hand side of the screen in columns A and B, you'll see a list of all your state jurisdiction names and FIPS codes. Each row represents a different jurisdiction. Before you begin entering data, please check your jurisdiction names to make sure there aren't any errors. If you see errors, please let us know and we'll fix them immediately. You'll also see that we pre-filled your state name in column L. If you scroll right, you'll see that each column in the spreadsheet is a different question. You can see that question A1A is in column O, question A1B is in column P, and so on. Row 7 contains the question number, and rows 4 through 6 have instructions on how to answer the questions. These are just abbreviated instructions, and you can find the full question instructions in the PDF version of the survey. If you scroll further to the right, you'll see that some questions have total check columns like this one in column AH that helps you check the subtotals to make sure that they're correct. Columns are not part of the survey, they're just there to help you check your math as you enter in data. You can consult the guide to using the 2018 data templates for more info about how to use these columns. There are also places for you to leave comments on each question. You can see here that in column AI, it contains a comments section for question A3. These comments are optional, but we encourage you to use them to give us more information and context behind your data responses. One other feature I want to show you is, if you'll scroll left to the beginning of the spreadsheet, is the gray error check button in cell A5. This is how you can check your data as you're entering it in. Now let's get started entering data into this template. The Excel data aggregation template lets you enter in data in a number of ways. You can type data directly into a cell, or you can copy and paste the data. This is especially helpful if you're able to pull a data report from your election management system. You can copy and paste the data one row at a time, one column at a time, or portions of data, just as you would with any other Excel spreadsheet. You can copy from a variety of source files, not just Excel documents. You can copy from Word, PowerPoint, or text files. I'm going to scroll to the right to question A1 again so I can show you some of these data entry functionalities. First, I'm going to enter in some data for the first jurisdiction in my state in row 8. You can see that in cell 06, there are some instructions for what answers are acceptable for this question. I can either enter a number or I can enter a not applicable or NA response. Please note that there are two different kinds of NA responses, negative 99 and negative 88. The PDF survey has more information on the difference between these NA responses and when you should use them. I've clicked on cell 08, so I can enter in data for question A1A. Now the instructions tell me that I can either enter a number in this cell or I can enter an NA. I'm going to type in my numerical response to this question. Some of the questions in the survey use pulldown menus instead of asking you to enter a number or text. I'm going to scroll over to question D9 to demonstrate this for you. You'll see that the instructions for this question in cell KX6 tell you to see the pull-down menu. So if I click on cell KX8, it will show me the options to choose from. If I try to type in a response in this cell, it will show me an error that the value I entered is not valid. However, with these pull-down menus, there's a way to trick Excel. If I copy and paste text into these questions, it will override that error message. Be very careful when you're copying and pasting directly into these columns that you're using the correct data. Another type of question to be aware of is these other specified text type of questions that you can see in question E2. And this is about the reasons why provisional ballots were rejected. There are several rejection reasons already built into the question, but your office might have rejected a provisional ballot for another reason. In that case, you'd use E2K to report it. If you record any numbers in E2K, you need to use the E2K_other column to describe the category. Now that I've walked you through some ways to enter your data into the Excel template, I'm going to switch and add some fake data that's used for just for the purposes of testing. You can see I've entered data for 3 of the 5 counties in this spreadsheet. Now I'm going to run the error check. This is a set of built-in macros and validations that will identify items that need further review and will help make sure your data submission is as complete and correct as it can be. You don't need to have entered in all of your data to run these data reviews. They'll run on just the data you've entered. Keep in mind also that the more data you've entered, the longer the macros will take to run. Also, whenever you run the data checks, it will remove all of the formatting in your data. So if you've copied and pasted in any data that has a different cell color, text color, underlining or bolding or italicizing, all of that will be removed once you click the error check button in cell A5, as I'm going to do right now. Our validations are now complete. The first thing that you'll notice is that we have some new tabs that have been added to this spreadsheet. We have one called Raw Error Codes and one that's named for your state. These are two versions of the error report, and they list the same items, but the second tab is designed to be a little more user-friendly, so that's what I'll show you. This tab contains a list of all the potential errors that were flagged when I clicked the error check button. It lists the FIPS codes and name of the jurisdiction in columns A and B, the variable that needs further review in column C, the exact cell that needs to review in column E, and a description of the issue in column D. This will help you identify which data points need to be reviewed and what corrections could be made. These macros will flag things like if you haven't inputted data for a required response, if your subcategories aren't adding up to the totals correctly, or if your responses aren't compatible with each other in some way. I'm going to scroll down through the report so you can see the issues that it's flagged and how the report's laid out. You can see further down in the report that it's clearly separated by jurisdiction. Another thing that will happen when you click the error check button is the template will automatically generate a row that calculates the totals for all the columns with the EAVS questions. I'm going to go back to the data entry tab and show you just how that works. You can see here that this state totals row has been placed 2 rows after the last jurisdiction in my data set. The template will do that automatically no matter how many jurisdictions you've entered into your spreadsheet. I'll scroll over to question A1A so you can see how it's added up the numbers. In A1A, the macros have taken the responses from those 3 counties and automatically summed them up, so you can see that for this state, there are 6,000 total registered voters. That number will be recalculated every time you hit the error check button. So if I enter in data for the last two counties and recheck the spreadsheet, their numbers will be reflected in that state total row. Now that you have a list of items to review, let's talk about how you respond to them. We ask that you go through each item carefully and do your best to respond. If you need to correct one of your responses, you can do that right here in the Data Entry tab. If I scroll further to the right, you can see the data validations have color-coded cells. An orange cell means that there's a math issue. Green cells mean you've entered a number that's incompatible with another response you've entered. Yellow cells mean that you should verify that your response is zero, and light blue means that you haven't entered a response yet. There will also only be one color code per cell, so be careful when checking a cell with multiple issues. I'm going to go to cell Q8 for question A1C. You can see here that it's colored light blue to signal that there's no data entered there yet. If this cell is blank because I just forgot to input the data, then I could type the correct number into this cell. However, sometimes there's a good reason why you don't have a number to input here. If my jurisdiction doesn't distinguish between active and inactive voters, then I would fill in negative 88 in this cell to indicate that this question does not apply to my jurisdiction. I would then use the A1 comments box in cell R8 to describe why I'm giving this answer. Now, if my data is actually correct, but the template is still flagging it with an error, I can use the comment boxes for each question to explain. It won't make the error flag go away, but it will give context to my data so that the EAC and Forest Marsh Group understand how to analyze and report my data correctly. Now that I've shown you how to run the validation checks and correct items in this template, note that you can run these checks as often as you want. Each time you click the error check button, we'll run the same set of validations and it will delete the previous reports and generate a brand new one. In fact, if I rerun the validation checks on my corrected data, you'll see that it's no longer flagging cell Q8 with a color code. I'll remind you that your validation check macros will probably take longer to run than you see in this video, since I don't have very much data in the spreadsheet. If your macros take several minutes to run on your data, don't be alarmed and don't interrupt the template. Just let it run to completion. Up to this point, I've shown you how to download and open the Excel Data Aggregation Template on your computer. I've shown you how to enter in your data and check it for issues to correct. And the last step, once you've entered in all of your data and are sure it's complete and correct to the best of your knowledge, is to submit your template. First, you'll want to save all the changes you've made by clicking the Save button. Then return to the EAVS portal, click Login in the upper right-hand corner or center of the page, enter in your credentials, we're now going to use the file upload function, which is the first thing on the page to submit the template. Click the Choose File button and from there navigate to where you saved your template on your local computer. Please note, if you've saved multiple versions of the template, make sure you select the most recent or most up-to-date version. From there, click Open, and then underneath the file path that you see here, click the Upload File button. Give it just a little time to process the upload, and if it worked, you'll see this message, File Upload Successful, appear in green underneath the File Upload header. You can verify it by looking for it in your uploaded files list, and you can see here that the file I just uploaded is listed. If the upload doesn't work, you'll get an error message in red text that will describe why the upload failed. So that is the process of using the Excel Data Aggregation Template for the 2018 EAVS study. We've discussed how to find your customized template on the EAVS portal, how to download and open it, how to enter data and check for errors and correct, and how to submit your completed template. You can find a written version of these instructions on the resources page of the EAVS portal. If you run into any difficulties using the data aggregation template, please reach out to our technical assistance help desk. You can reach them at EAVS@forestmarshgroup.com, and someone will get back to you within one business day. Thank you, and we appreciate your time and your contributions to the EAVS survey.